Hi everyone, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a Catia consultant working for PLM technology in Norway. And today I'm going to do a live demonstration on the 3D experience release 19x on the cloud. I will show you how we can mesh a solid part using SIMULIA application and partitioning. Okay, so to start my demonstration, I will create a 3D part and we will make a pipe. So I will call it pipe solid mesh. Okay, here we have our part with the 3D shape. And I want to be sure that I'm in part design. So I will just make an elbow pipe. With an angle. Okay. So we can put some dimension. 200. We can say that we want, well, 75. And here 100. With an angle, of course. 60 sounds nice. I will maybe reduce a bit here, 60. Okay, we can just exit the sketch and we will make, so that was the guide curve. So we'll just make a profile curve now. I will make a circle. You want a diameter, but not too big. So 50 millimeters sounds okay. And I will use the feature rib. So the profile is here and the guide curve is this one. So here we have our pipe, but it's full. So you are going to use the feature thick profile and we can put 3 millimeter. That sounds actually pretty nice. Okay. Just for, before we continue the video, I can already make a material to that part. So I will just go to my material browser and you have many type of material, but what you want is a material that is a core material for applying a simulation property. And what about, you know what, I'm going to search for aluminium. Here it is, aluminium. And what about this one here? I used it before, so I think I know this one contains simulation property. And I will apply it to my pipe, to my part. Okay. And what I like here is that you can clearly see that the part contains the shape and the material separately. Yes, we have our simulation material properties here. Okay. And so that's good so far. I will just now make an abstraction shape. It's kind of a copy of this part here. I will just select this pipe. I will copy it. And I will go to the abstraction shape. And I will paste it with link. Meaning that if I modify my pipe, this abstraction will modify it as well. Okay. I will just add my 2D shape because we don't need it anymore. We are going to work on the abstraction shape. We can even call it abstraction pipe or solid pipe. Great. And in that shape here, we will just add a geometrical set because we want to partition this solid. So I will just call a plane or partitioning. Like that. And we can just reuse actually the sketch here. So let me see. If I go back in the shape here and I hide it, this sketch here we would like to reuse. So I can just copy and go back to the abstraction shape. Be in the geometrical set and past special as a result with link, of course. Yes, that's great. I will hide the 3D shape again, go back to abstraction solid pipe, and here I will just switch to generative shape design for making a surface. Extrude of this line here. Actually pick up the right direction, but the length is not long enough. So mirror extended. And you see here, we will partition the solid using the surface we just created. So we'll hide the sketch. And well, now actually we can just start going in the mesh editor. And how to do that? Well, again, you just insert a finite element model or mesh in your 3D part. And the 3D part will contain all this information. So let's call it mesh solid pipe, as we get here. Great. So we can go to the mesh here. It will ask us, are you going to do a mesh in the 3D shape or in the abstraction shape? And we want to do the abstraction. So then we can keep the original shape as it is. Okay, so he understood that. We can edit in model preparation. You can go to partition. So you probably have to be in the body here. And I will partition my solid using this surface. Split here. And okay. Let's hide the partitioning. And we can see here that we have a cut. That's pretty nice. And we will also do it one here. I will partition the solid with my plane. Okay, and now you get the partition here too. That's pretty good so far. Okay, we can just exit that, update, go to properties. That's we should make a mesh first. So we'll just go to mesh, and I will use the feature partition X mesh. And here it is. You can just pick up your body. Initialize from geometry, mesh, and it looks pretty good, but you can also refine it. Let's put 5 millimeter. Okay. Now you get your mesh. We can even do a quick visualization, if I'm right, or check. Quantile analysis looks green to me. So if you don't see it very well, you can just hide that then. Okay. And let's finish by just adding the properties, meaning that we want to have a solid section. So the support will be the body too, inside the abstraction shape, and the material is picked out as aluminium. And that's it. You made a solid mesh using partitioning in SIMULIA application. So thank you very much for watching this video. Do not hesitate to check our YouTube channel and subscribe to it. And also, if you have any questions, just contact us, add comments to the video, and I will reply. Thank you very much and have a nice day. Bye.